Okay, we're ready for the show?
I think so, yeah. I don't know.
Today is about one more.
Are you kidding me?
One more. So, I need you to go out there with a lot of energy, and give Donovan the absolute reputation it always deserves. Hey. And that is your very best.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Live Jesus
in our hearts forever. Amen.
The light of Christ is filling us, healing us, and protecting us, and making us the best doggone cast and crew ever to step on a stage.
Amen!
I know that all of you are tired. Just want to remind you that the important thing is that you breathe and support and use your technique. Bring that sound forward. We need you for tonight, the next day, and the next night. I was super proud of you guys. It was killer. It was really good. Really good. But now, what do we have to do?
Thank you.
Pacific Peace with our hands. Out of 28 postulants, 16 or 17 are ready to enter the novitiate. Now let's consider the doubt rules again. There's Ermagard. There can be no doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Ermagard. Religious life is no place for the pious? You mean the pretentiously pious Sister Berta. There's Christina. And there's Maria. Well, there can be no doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria. Especially not after last night. I gave her permission to leave the abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Berta.
Amen. Sister Sophie, the mistress of the novices and the mistress of the postulants do not seem to see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be in a bit of trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say.
Thank you.
You've been so kind in giving me permission to leave.
It wasn't about your being late, Maria.
Oh, I must have awakened half the abbey before Sister Mother Better heard me open the gate.
Very few of us were asleep. We could only think that you had lost your way. And to be lost at night on that mountain.
Reverend Mother, I couldn't be lost on that mountain. That's my mountain. It's the mountain that brought me to you.
Oh.
When I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain, climb a tree, and look over into your gardens. I'd see the sisters at work and hear them sing on their way to Vespers. Many times I'd go back in the dark, singing all the way. And that brings up another transgression. I was singing yesterday, and I was singing without your permission.
Maria, it's only here in the abbey that there is a rule about singing.
That's the hardest rule of all for me. And Sister Margaretta is always reminding me.
But too late. After I've already started singing. And the day we're singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
But Mother, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
That's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind, too. I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song myself as a child, but I can't quite remember. Please.
Thank you.
Even then, Maria, the dress you wore when you came to us, is that still in the living room?
We know. I'm sure that's been given to the poor. Sister Margaretta said when we entered the abbey unworthy.
Reverend Mother, why do you ask?
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Leave here? Oh, no, Mother, please, no!
Oh, I'll only leave.
But this is what I want. This is my life.
But are you ready for it? Perhaps if you go out into the world again for a time, you will return to us knowing what we expect of you, and that we do expect it.
But I know what you expect, Mother, and I'll do it, I promise.
Maria,
if it is the will of God, where am I to go?
There's a family of seven children. You like children. You're very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain Von Trapp is expecting you this afternoon. He's a fine man and a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
Captain in the Navy? Oh, Mother, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his battleship.
You wait here. I am Captain Montrap. You are Fräulein...
Marie. Maria Ray.
Fräulein, as to your duties here, would you mind stepping over there? Before the children meet you, you will put on another dress.
I haven't any other dress. When we enter the abbey, all our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
And what about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
This is what you would call a worldly dress.
It belonged to my last postulant. I would have made myself a new dress, but I wasn't given time. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you're given some material, today if possible. Now, you will be in charge of my children. There are seven of them. You will find out how far they have progressed in their studies and carry on from there. Each morning is spent in the classroom. Each afternoon they march. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with orderliness and decorum. The first rule of this house is discipline.
Yes, sir!
This is your new Fräulein, Fräulein Maria. As I sound off your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, will listen and learn their signal so you can call them when you want.
Liesel.
Friedrich.
Luisa. Brigitta. Mark. Kurt.
Now, Fräulein, let's see how well you listen.
Well,
never been a governess before. Where do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is to tell Father to mind his own business.
No, he's dumb. I like him.
What's in here?
My guitar.
What did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you sing. Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes just happen to be.
every year on this day, there was a birthday telegram from a sister.
You see? You are wonderful.
Can I come again tomorrow night?
Rolf, you can't be sure you're going to be telling him to deliver you tomorrow night.
Well, I can come here by mistake with a telegram for Colonel Schneider. He's in for Berlin. He's staying with the daughter, but no one's supposed to know that. Don't tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Some think we ought to be German. They're really mad at those who don't think so. They're getting ready to... Let's hope your father doesn't get any trouble.
Don't worry about father. He was decorated for bravery.
I don't worry about him. The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you?
16. What's wrong with that?
Oh,
trap children never play. The captain doesn't like them getting dirty. But they're children. They have to climb trees and roll in the grass while thinking of frogs and caves.
The captain says the best exercise is marching. The children will continue to march. I hope you find your room comfortable.
Oh, yes, thank you.
Oh, there will be new curtains for the window of the alcove. They will be hung tomorrow.
But these curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
Oh, I don't know. Of course, he has to come home every time he hires new governess.
I sometimes think the children get rid of their governesses just because they want to see their
father.
Well, he must want to see them too.
Since his wife died, he reminded me too much of her. You can put that away. You won't be using it.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
He won't have music.
And he used to love music. Oh, there were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing, and he would play the violin and guitar. Now he shut up all that out of his life.
That's why he used the way he used. But to not have music, well, that's wrong for him, and wrong for the children, too.
It will work out. The captain may marry again when the summer is over.
That would change everything. Well, they'd have a new mother.
It's going to rain. You better close your window.
Dear God, I now know that you have sent me here on a mission. I must help these children to love their new mother. Prepare them to win her love so that she will never want them to leave her. And may this be a happy family in our sight. God bless the captain, Liesel, Friedrich, Louisa, Gita, Marta, and Loka. And I forgot the other one's name. Well, God bless what's his name. Margarella and all the sisters in all the reality. And now, dear God, about Liesel. Help her to know that I am her friend, and help her to tell me what she's up to.
Are you going to tell on me?
Help me to be understanding so that I may guide her in her footsteps. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
I was out taking a walk, and somebody walked through us earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake anybody up. So when I saw your window open, you're not going to tell Father, are you?
Did you climb the trellis to get up here?
That's how we always get in this room to play tricks on the governess. Louisa can climb it with a toad in her hand.
Liesel, were you walking outside all by yourself?
You know, if we wash this out tonight, nobody will notice tomorrow.
Then all of this will just be between you and me.
Here, you can put this on. Take your dress to soak in the bathtub, and we'll have a little talk. I told you today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, no. It was Kurtz.
Oh, that's the one I left out.
God bless Kurt.
The lightning says something to the thunder, and then the thunder answers back.
I wish it wouldn't answer so loud.
Well, maybe if we all sing loud enough, we can hear it.
Like the rest of the sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village. That's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt his feelings.
It's fun being with you. You're quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there's a fascinated man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him. And when I do, he's excited.
Exciting? I have never been called exciting before.
I'm beginning to understand you a little better now that I see you here. You know, you're a little bit like the mountains. Except you keep moving. How do you stay away from this place as long as you are?
Maybe I've been searching for a reason to come back here instead.
Gail, I'd like you. Very good.
Max can still be on the telephone. I know he's busy trying to find tickets for the Cosbury Festival, but... You like it here?
Oh, we have to spend some time in Vienna. I have Heinrich's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is. And I'm president.
You? President of a corporation?
I managed Heinrich's affairs 4 years before he died.
I can't see you sitting behind the desk.
Oh, yes, I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, sir. Erica will like his coffee now.
While he's telephoning, he just finished.
I'm sorry it took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Cosmic Festival? The finest corporate group in all of Austria, the greatest expert in all of Europe, and the best of China in the world.
That's something I would love to hear.
So would I. And all I got up to now is a boss who isn't even profundo.
Max, you always come up with a good festival.
And why? Because my motto is never set out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Rome, Stockholm, Paris, London.
On Georg's telephone?
Of course. How else could I afford it? Why am I up here?
I hoped it was because you liked me.
Of course I like you. Why shouldn't I like you? You live like a king. And you have an excellent wine
cellar.
Max. I like rich people. I like the way you live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Is there a cathedral out here?
That's the Abbey, the Nonnery Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Excellent. In the next few days, I'll be visiting all the towns around here with me to sonnet runs, choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. There's a town just about that size, Watsonville, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the festival and became very famous. They even toured all over the world.
Yes. And whatever happened to them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Won't put still to you?
Baron Emmerfeld, the oldest family in the valley.
I'd love to meet him. I'd love to meet all your friends. Gail, why don't you have a dinner for me while I'm here? Nothing very much. Just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Today it's difficult to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
Oh, now's not a good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You aren't worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Oh, it couldn't have been an intentional slight, considering they haven't met me yet.
Forgive me. I'll try to find them.
Elsa, have you made up your mind yet? Is Georg going to marry you?
Yes. Well, he hasn't admitted yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
You don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What is it?
It's simple. It's money.
Money?
Oh, yes. He's rich, and you're rich. All the famous love affairs and lovers have to struggle. Girl, room to wait upstairs and lovers, stark as novel. Famous for misfortune, which they seem to have no fear of. While lovers, you are very rich, you're very self.
Not in the way I've said them.
prostrate in the gardens.
Yes, show me the gardens. I want to see everything. All you do. Now, I don't know any of your names yet, but that doesn't matter. I'm sure I won't get this straight for a very long time.
My name is Marta.
He is not.
My name is
You were right. I don't know my own children.
Waiting to know you. They want so much to do. After I've gone.
No. I want you to stay.
I can be of any help.
You've already helped. You've brought music back into my home. I have forgotten.
German blood, haven't you?
I am not German. I'm Austrian.
Well, it's going to be the Anschluss, and I want you, and everybody like you, and that goes for hours.
Be quiet.
It's much more pleasant on the terrace. Baron Edelfeld, it's very nice to have you in the Baroness here again.
That's right, charming, Gail.
I hope you do know.
Oh, no, just a headache. I'm on my way up to get her. I'll meet you on the terrace.
Father, I don't think these people are having a very good time.
Half the people I invited aren't speaking to the other half.
Well, Father, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Oh, sir, Frau Schroeder asked me to let you know that she can join you in the group.
Thank you. You might see whether she would like this glass of bread.
You're not serious.
But of course.
She's a nursemaid.
I don't think of her that way.
I don't mind, but your friend's gay, you can't expect him to die with her.
Why not?
Elsa, tell him why not.
Max, can you change to her?
Yes, Max. We can use you tonight.
Come on, I've been dodging these people for an hour.
Brigida, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Odella. It's nice to see you.
Yes, you're going to.
I knew it all along. Frau Schrader didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party. She was faking.
Brigida, you can't say things you don't know are true.
But I do know. I heard her say to Father she'd been dodging these people all night.
Brigida, that's just the kind of thing. It's very important to judge my fresh here.
Well, I am all right. Why is it important?
Well, I think she's going to be your new mother.
Oh, Fräulein, Father's never going to marry her. Why, he couldn't.
Why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigida, that's just the kind of thing.
Oh, you must know that.
Brigida, no.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing the Everlife song he taught us? Well, after we finished, he laughed at me for forgetting the words. But he didn't forget the words. He stopped singing just to look at you. And when he talks to you, the way his voice sounds.
No, Brigida, no.
Oh, Fräulein, you won't be having dinner with the children tonight. You'll be eating down here with us. Oh, yes, it's all been arranged. You'll have to change. You'll have to hurry. Maria, wear that dress you wore the other night when we were all singing. It was lovely. It's all been arranged.
Shall I announce dinner, Captain?
The children will want to say goodnight. Gail, I wanted the children to say goodnight the way they did last night.
No, not here.
Why not? The way they did it for me? So sweet.
No, not in front of strangers.
Oh, please, Gail. For me?
What's so changed up?
Max, you are just in time. Children, now.
this for the festival, and I find it here.
Wait just a minute, Matt.
A singing group of seven children in one family.
But Georg didn't want them to sing in front of the guests tonight. I have to persuade him.
Ah, we have no words. We must talk to him.
Yes.
Elsa, this is important to our ship. And it wouldn't do me any harm.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know that I did. And
just